ihram. To perform the rituals, the one who is performing Hajj and Umrah has to be in a state of ihram. Ihram literally means prevention, and the scholars of fiqh described it as the intention to start the religious rites and at the same time perform any of the prescribed acts of worship of Hajj. It is recommended for the muhrim to have a bath, to remove the armpit and pubic hairs, and trim the moustache as well as the fingernails. Similarly, the male muhrim removes all fitted garments or al-makhiq before assuming ihram and wears a white loincloth, a white robe and sandals. This is due to the statement of the Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him: any one of you who intends to perform Hajj or Umrah should assume ihram in a loincloth and robe and a pair of sandals. If he cannot find sandals, he should put on a pair of khufs, meaning leather socks, but he must cut them to be below the ankles. As for a woman, she can assume ihram with whatever clothes she prefers. There is no prescribed color for her ihram, but she must avoid resembling men and wearing adornments. And she is also not to wear the veil or gloves during ihram. But when she is in the presence of men who are strangers or non-mahram to her, she must cover her face by pulling some of her clothes on the top of her head over her face. It is also recommended for one performing Hajj to wear perfume when assuming ihram, due to Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, statement: I used to perfume the Messenger of Allah, peace and blessings be upon him, for the purpose of ihram at the time he intended it. But the ihram clothes are not to be perfumed due to the statement of the Messenger, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him: do not put on clothes to which saffron or al-wars have been applied. There are many acts that are prohibited when one is in the state of ihram. It is prohibited to shave, trim or pluck the hair, as Allah the Most High said, and do not shave your heads until the hadi reaches the place of sacrifice. This ruling is applicable to any hair on the body being deduced through analogy from the rule relating to the hair on the head. Similarly, it is prohibited for the muhrim to clip his or her nails, and it is prohibited for the male to cover his head with any attached fitting object. We have the Prophet, peace be upon him, describing the clothes of a muhrim by saying, do not wear shirts, turbans, trousers or hooded cloaks. And he, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, said concerning a muhrim who had died, do not cover his head because he will be raised on the day of resurrection, saying the talbiyah. However, if this covering were not to touch the head, for example by using an umbrella or sunshade, tent, roof of a building or car, then there is no sin in this whatsoever. It is also prohibited for a male muhrim to wear fitted garments, that is trousers, shirts, khufs or leather socks, woolen socks, gloves, etc. If the person intending ihram does not find a loincloth, then he can put on trousers until he finds a loincloth. Furthermore, if he does not have a pair of sandals, he can put on khufs or leather socks. This is in accordance with the statement of the Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, and if he cannot find sandals, he should put on khufs or leather socks, but he must cut them to be below the ankles. It is forbidden for the muhrim to perfume his body and clothes after assuming ihram. This is due to the hadith by Ibn Umar, may Allah be pleased with him: do not put on clothes to which saffron or wars have been applied. Similarly, it is forbidden for a muhrim to kill or hunt land game. As Allah the Most High said, O you who believe, kill not the game while you are in a state of ihram for Hajj. And whosoever of you kills it intentionally, the penalty is an offering brought to the Kaaba of an eatable animal equivalent to the one he killed, as adjudged by two just men among you. Or for expiation, he should feed masakin, meaning poor persons, or its equivalent in sawm, meaning fast, that he may taste the heaviness, meaning the punishment, of his deed. Allah has forgiven what is past, but whosoever commits it again, Allah will take retribution from him, and Allah is the Almighty and the All-Able of retribution. And also his statement, But forbidden is land game as long as you are in the state of ihram. What is meant by land game is every wild animal or bird that is permissible for consumption. However, domestic animals are not regarded as game. Thus, it is permissible for the muhrim to slaughter chickens and livestock, etc. As for sea animals, they are permissible. This is due to the statement of Allah the Exalted, lawful to you is water, game, and its use for food. As for animals that are forbidden to be eaten, such as snakes, scorpions, etc., their killing is permissible. It is permissible for the muhrim to kill any animal that is harmful if he cannot defend himself by other than killing it. It is prohibited for a muhrim to carry out any marriage contract. As the Prophet, peace be upon him, said, a person in a state of ihram must neither marry himself nor arrange the marriage of another one, nor should he make the proposal of marriage. Sexual intercourse is also forbidden for the muhrim. This is according to the statement by Allah, the Most High. So whoever intends to perform Hajj therein by assuming ihram, then he should not have sexual relations. Similarly, it is forbidden for a muhrim to partake in foreplay in areas other than the private parts, like kissing and caressing, as they are means leading to sexual intercourse, which is forbidden. The scholars wrote many important points concerning ihram. One of them being that there is no basis for what is called salatu sunnah, or two units of voluntary salah at the instance of assuming ihram. Just as there is no particular supplication when assuming ihram. The scholars also explained that if a traveler is traveling by plane and fears he might not be able to put on the ihram garment when he arrives at the miqat, the place where the ihram garment is worn, he should wear it from his home or at the airport. But he does not become muhrim by doing so until he makes the intention to perform the religious rites before nearing or reaching the miqat. Another point which the scholars noted is that some pilgrims bear their right shoulder, which is referred to as al-ittiba', all the time they are wearing the ihram garment. But al-ittiba' is only done during the tawaf al-qudum, that is, the circumambulation performed upon arrival. As for other times, the muhrim should cover his two shoulders. If hairs fall from the head of a muhrim during ablution or during bathing due to wiping or scrubbing, this does not harm him and no sin is involved. Neither does the loss of hairs from his mustache, beard, or any part of the nails falling off involve any sin, as long as all these are not intentional. It is permissible for a muhrim to tie a string, ribbon, or cord on his leg if he needs that, or he may benefit from its use. One of the points that the scholars have mentioned is that whoever has an ailment or fears that something may happen which might hinder him from completing the Hajj rites, it is recommended for him to state a condition when assuming ihram by saying, O Allah, I answered your call for Umrah, or the like. But if anything hinders me from completing it, then the place of my being released, meaning the place of disengagement from the Hajj or Umrah rites, is the place where I am hindered. That is, if I am hindered by this impediment, I will free myself of my state of ihram at the place I am hindered and not complete the rites of Hajj or Umrah. On the authority of Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, it has been reported that the Prophet entered upon Dhuba'ah bint Zubayr and said to her, it seems you want to perform Hajj. She said, by Allah, I do not see anything preventing me except for a waji'ah or pain. He, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, then said, perform Hajj and be conditional in your intention by saying, O Allah, my place of release from the Hajj rites is wherever I am hindered. When this is said and anything restrains him, then it is permissible for him to be released of the Hajj rites. He does not have to compensate with anything for not completing them.